What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigoscode. In this video, I want to talk to you about the ideal software engineer. You know, this channel is all about giving you the tips, allowing you to be successful in your career as a software engineer. Now, I'm going to be describing some qualities which I feel you should have in order to be the ideal software engineer. If you're new to my channel, go ahead and subscribe. Also, give me a thumbs up so I can keep on recording these videos. Now, in order for you to be the ideal software engineer, I think that you should be able to pick up any language, right? So just think of a language, of a programming language, as a tool to solve a problem. There are times where people say, do you know what? I'm just a backend guy, or I'm just a frontend guy. I think that you should never say that, because a programming language or a framework is just a tool for you to solve a problem. And as a software engineer, you should be able to pick both the backend and both the frontend and just code in any language, to be honest, right? You should be able to do that. So that will set you apart from the competition. And to be honest, it is fine for you to have a preference whether you like more backend or frontend, but don't say, oh, you know what? I only do backend or I only do frontend. You should be able to do both at the same time, right? You might be stronger on the backend, that is fine, and weaker on the front end. But make sure that you understand exactly, for example, if you need to make a change on the UI, you can do it. If you need to make a change on the back end, you can also do it, because that will make you a much better software engineer. Now, I remember when I switched from, I was doing back end and full stack, and I moved to DevOps. To be honest, like, that changed everything, because I was able to do the back end, I was able to do the front end, and then I was able to also do the infrastructure and understand how everything was put together. And overall, that was a great experience. And now I can take any project and understand exactly the overall process from local machine all the way to production. And I can also implement backend, frontend, infrastructure, and I understand about the cloud, which is really, really awesome. So if you have all of those skills, then it puts you in a position where recruiters or companies will hire you, right? And they will pay money for you, like big money, just for you to have all of those skills. And the message that I want to pass on is that don't just focus on the back end, or don't just focus on the front end, right? So just be a software engineer that has an understanding of the overall piece. Now, obviously, when it comes to back end, you've got, database design, you have to understand SQL or NoSQL, depending on the database that you use, transactions, constraints, and all that stuff, right? So that's a separate topic, but what I'm saying is you should be able to do both. Also, the ideal software engineer is someone that understands, for example, how to take their application and then run it, right? So in the cloud these days. So for example, Docker and Kubernetes today are so popular, and you should be aware of those technologies. What is a container? What is an image? How do you run containers? How do you take your containers and then have an orchestration tool such as Kubernetes that makes sure that your application is always up and running, right? So understanding, you don't have to be, you know, genius on it, but having a good understanding will set you apart. Also, the cloud provider. So whether it is AWS, GCP, or Azure, just understand, for example, what is an EC2, what is a VM, what is security groups, networking, VPCs, and all of that stuff, right? Because that way, if you want to troubleshoot something in the cloud, then you kind of have an understanding of how things work. Now, again, here, you don't have to be the master, but just having an understanding of all of these things will make you a much better software engineer. And also, in my opinion, I think that communication, it's really important, being able to express what you want to do, right? So communication between your team, the organization, and, you know, just taking the requirements and then translate those into code sometimes can be really challenging, right? So if you don't understand what they're talking to you, then it's going to be really difficult for you to put it into code, right? So communication and understanding what you need to do, it's really important. Also, you should be someone that is a mentor, right? So whatever you learn, don't just keep it to yourself, right? You have to make sure that you spread the knowledge. So that will be beneficial for you, because you will improve your own skills, right? But also you are sharing knowledge, which in the long term will be beneficial, because the team will improve over and over and over, right? So sharing knowledge is important. Be a leader as well, right? Be a leader. So don't be like an awkward software engineer that doesn't like to engage or doesn't like to talk to others. Them software engineers are always are on their headphones and just listen to God knows what, and there's no interaction. No. Just have interaction amongst other, and try to be a leader, right? Because what you have to understand is as you grow, so from junior, mid, senior, you're not going to be coding, 100% down the line, right? There are times where you're going to have to, attend a bunch of meetings, or maybe you're going to become an architect, right? So this is where you have to, put the application together from the high level view, right? So these are things that, as time progresses, you're going to have to, move maybe into a management role, which I feel like it's ideal, right? Because now you can share, your knowledge, you can empower others. And so this is what will make the company drive forward. So if the company has great leaders, then that can be, the success of the company, right? So usually people work in companies where, there's mentorship, people look after each other. And the reason why I'm telling you this is because as you learn, I want you to go off and help others, inspire others, right? Don't just be like an awkward engineer. I don't want that. I want you to be the ideal software engineer that has an understanding about all of these different things. Now, I don't expect you to be, 100% good in everything. So you can have your strongest side, backend, database design, cloud, so on and so forth. But it is essential that you have an understanding from A to Z, the process of building applications, the process of building software, right? Because then it will put you in a position where you know exactly what you're doing. And, when coming, for example, to be on call, then you know exactly, how to navigate around the system and understand how things are put together. So, so this is what I'm trying to do with the Amigoscode. So I'm providing you guys with backend content, DevOps content. I haven't done much of React and front-end stuff. I will do it, but just at the moment, I've got a bunch of content on the backend side because I think that's what you guys are more interested. But yeah, so let me know what you want to see next, courses. There's plenty of new courses on my website, which I highly recommend you check them out. There's there's a 30% off on majority of the courses. So one last thing that I want to say is own it, own it, right? So this is the thing. Don't expect somebody to maintain your code, right? So if you implement something, take ownership, right? So don't say, I just implement it and then I've got testers. No, you should be the one testing your code, right? So testing is really important. Again, I also have a complete course on unit testing, test-driven development, integration testing external APIs and parties. So this channel, Amigoscode, is here to make you a better software engineer. If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. And join the private Facebook group as well as Discord. Over 30,000 people combined. And this is all for now. I'll catch you in the next one. Assalamu alaikum.